PP the Tool Addict here, coming at you. How you doing? This is the peak of my day. I'm really pumped and running hard, and unfortunately today it's slow. We're here in good old Antarctica, Iowa, whatever you want to do. You know, I'm not very good at pronouncing words sometimes. You guys have heard me on the channel. Sometimes I'm like, blah, 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 blah. You know, I got issues like that, you know. I need a speech therapist. But I'm a mechanic, so I'm not here to be anything but tell you about tools and stuff like that. I'm not here to be an English teacher. I'm not here to be a speech therapist. I'm here to just tell you the facts or what I've experienced throughout my years. Anyways, nonetheless, I'll quit babbling on. Want to talk to you guys today. You seen it in the title. Tool trucks, vendors, so on and so forth. And what makes a guy a great tool guy and what makes a guy a bad tool guy? The first thing we're going to talk about here is, how do you know if your tool dealer is a good tool dealer? Well, I'll tell you right now. When you ask him a question, he gives you a straight answer. That's the bottom line. If I ask a tool dealer, you know, hey, is this made by you guys? And he says, oh yeah, and it's not, you know, that's a bad tool dealer right there. I'm going to tell you right now, as a tool dealer, an ex-tool dealer, the one biggest thing you don't want to do is get caught up in lies. When you get caught up in lies, it takes away your accreditation. So, just remember that. If you want to find out if your tool dealer is a good tool dealer, get a product off his truck that you know is made by somebody else and they're rebranding it. Ask him who makes it. If he tells you the truth, bam, you know you got yourself a good tool dealer. That guy gives you a little bit of a bullshit story. Well, there you go. There's a dumb number one biggest thing right there. I'm not telling you to incriminate your tool dealer by any means. Some guys are new and they have a little bit of trouble, you know, breaking in that. But they drink the Kool-Aid right away when they start off getting into the tool truck business. And that's a problem. You know, you got to understand as a tool dealer, what they tell you when they're training you to be a tool dealer isn't always the best practices for the business that you do. There's going to be a ton of probably tool dealers that might crucify me for putting out this video, because this is probably unspoken, unwritten laws that have been out there for years. But, you know, I'm going to tell you the insider deals about tool truck businesses. The tool truck business is tough, okay? So when you listen to people and they tell you that buying off the tool truck or buying from these big companies is terrible, well, I'm going to tell you one thing right now. They have no clue, none whatsoever, how hard it is to be a tool dealer. So I'm going to give those guys a little bit of credit right now, because I'm going to tell you right now, first time for being a tool dealer, the guy that's on the tool truck is not the problem. It's the company. If you have an issue, it's the company. The tool truck dealers, 9 times out of 10, don't want to have to bend you over for a price. They don't want to have to treat you unfairly. They're there to help you out, and they really do want to help you out. A lot of them are very passionate. I've met very few tool dealers that don't want to help you out. They want to be a good tool dealer for you, and they want to get a good name and reputation. Now, sometimes things happen, life situations, you know, so on and so forth, that causes that tool dealer to get behind. I hear a lot of guys get down on their tool dealer. Oh, my guy's going out of business. Snap-on sucks. Mac sucks. Matco sucks. We don't have a dealer, blah, blah, blah. That doesn't define the company, okay? That defines one man, one person that ran the route. You could come in and have another guy that's a great guy. So when you get ready to dog these tool dealers, remember one thing right now. Was it the tool dealer? Was it the company? There'll be a lot of people, and this will probably stir up all sorts of controversy. But I'm telling you right now, business nowadays is not that easy. The internet keeps everything competitive, okay? You can literally look up something at the flash of an eye. So if your guy comes in and he has something for sale, and he wants to say, hey, CP, I want to sell you this. You don't think I'm not going to go to Google or eBay and check out this stuff, Amazon, everything, and look at it and see how bad he's really going to get me for? So, you know, these are some tips that are probably not conducive to most tool truck guys', you know, favorite way to do things. But I'll tell you what, it's a fair practice. We got to keep everybody honest out here in the business. I have to deal with it, so why shouldn't tool trucks have to deal with it? A competitor will literally go down the street and ask for somebody, hey, CP, I can get this done in such and such for way cheaper. Why don't you do it? Hook me up. Well, here's the thing, guy. that doesn't pay the bills for me, okay? It might help. They might pay the bills to them. But then next week when they're out of business, what are you going to do? You're going to go on to the next guy. Customer is, to be a loyal customer is a very hard thing to get nowadays. So I implore you, if you have a good tool truck dealer, be a good customer to your tool truck dealer. Make be honest to them and they'll be honest to you. I've had my ups and downs as dealing with a tool truck dealer and being on the tool truck and dealing with customers. You know, sometimes life happens and you have to be understanding of what's going on in that person's life. Some of the greatest customers I had made me think at one time that they were going to screw me over, and they became some of my best customers ever. You know, for instance, I had a guy one time, give you a little story, who got on my truck, spent about $2,500, paid for it all cash. Never seen from him for a couple weeks. Then all of a sudden he got back on, bought a few more things, told me he was going to pay me. Then I never seen him for 6 months, okay? Then he came back in 6 months, got on my truck, paid me off, bought another $2,500, paid that off, and then continuously we got onto a system that worked out good, okay? These are how you have to understand that, you know, tool dealers and customers are just, you have different things going on in your life. Tool dealers don't always understand what's going on in a mechanic's life, and a mechanic don't always understand what's going on in a tool dealer's life. A tool dealer could potentially have bills they need to get paid. They have life circumstances, and they need money for those circumstances. And that's why they get a little bit brash and might want to push and maybe get their payments. Does that make them a bad person? No, it doesn't. But you need to work with them, and they need to be honest with you. In a business such as that, you have to be honest with your customers. You have to be honest with the people that you're dealing with. Only thing that will always make things work for you is being honest. I promise you, karma will come get you if you are being dishonest in your business. That's all there is to it. You know, lying to people and giving them the runaround is not the way to go. It's all it is it's taking you down a rabbit hole of turmoil. Okay, so don't deal with that. Tool dealers have their place, and you can make great deals with them. Buying stuff on flyers, for instance, is definitely promotional prices. That is definitely the number one way to buy tools. If you stick to buying most of your stuff on promotional prices, you will always have fairly decent deals. Now, that doesn't mean that they'll always be decent, but if you do your research, you'll know. Okay? Now, there's a lot of people out there that are promoting against tool trucks, and that's fine because they promote places that don't promote American-made stuff. They promote companies that aren't producing in the U.S. and they try to justify that by saying, well, they employ people. They employ people at barely above minimum wage too. Okay, and that's terrible. I'm sorry, but you have a better shot as being a tool dealer and then having people employed. The amount of money that's spread around in that is a far more better income than somebody who's working at Harbor Freight. I'm going to go out and say that right now. Okay, beside that, I think Harbor Freight has become the bottom feeder of the tool industry. I mean, they literally sweep up the garbage and sell it in their stores. That is all they do. If you look at all the rebranded stuff and stuff that they get, I mean, it's not any better than most of the other stuff. You have great companies like Capri, Tecton, Gray Pneumatic, Sonex. These guys are killing it, and they have a reasonably good price if you're not looking to buy it. I'm even the Power Torch stuff. You guys have recently seen that stuff. I am impressed every day with the amount of quality that's coming out of some tool companies. You know, Doug Yoda sent me a little email about the Power Torch stuff. I didn't even realize that there's some Japanese stuff called SK11 that Power Torch stuff is kind of mimicking. And that's quality Japanese stuff. But anyways, I kind of got off on a tangent there a little bit. But my point being said is that you have different levels in the tool industry. A tool truck is a top dog. That's all there is to it. A tool truck sells you the best quality they can. Do they always have the best quality? No! Okay, and all of you guys, if you can't have a reasonable discussion in that comment box, I don't even want to talk to you. This is about a discussion that you got to be open-minded about. That's all there is to it. You can't just come into this conversation and just have an angry attitude towards Snap-on or Mac or Matco or Cornwell. You have to have an open-minded attitude. If you want to talk about something about tool industries, and you have to say to yourself, okay, are you going to accept Taiwanese tools and pay a lesser price? Because that's what it is. When it comes down to getting that price, that's what you're going to have to pay. If you want to buy USA-made quality stuff, then you have to be willing to accept that you're going to pay a little bit more. People in America deserve to get paid more. We have a better living. We have a great country. Okay, is it worth paying those people a little bit more so we can have tools made here? So we can keep our economy hot? Yes, it is. It is. Sorry. So anyways, before you bash on the tool truck, before you complain about the tool truck, remember, ask yourself one question. Is it the tool truck? Is it the company? Or is it my dealer? Because great dealers are all over there. I have a lot of great dealers in my area. And I'll tell you right now, I can deal with them all. I've not had anything really bad. Now, I know that I've been a little bit hard on Matco lately, but that's because the company itself is you know, I've just understand how much rebranding they're doing, but the price is getting in out of control. And so I want to address that. Why I don't hate Matco, guys. I like Matco stuff. Matco is definitely a upper echelon of tool company. They definitely give they make quality stuff, or they get quality, they have quality stuff built. But the thing about it is Matco is also having some of these companies like VIM, Capri, Sun-X, you know, Gray Pneumatic. These companies are building stuff for them. So you got to ask yourself, if those are the companies that they're using to build for them, then why not just buy direct from them? Olsa Tools, Tecton. I mean, Olsa is really coming up as a player in the game too, in my opinion. If you guys haven't checked out Olsa Tool stuff, you might want to check them out. I do have a discount code for them. It's CPT10 if you guys are looking to buy anything from Olsa. Great company. I've had a conversation with them. Man, what a fantastic company they are. So, you know, that all goes on along with the tool truck stuff. If those companies are rebranding their stuff, that means that they're building professional grade quality stuff. And you should check them out. before you have to always buy off the tool truck. Does it mean that buying off the tool truck is bad? Once again, no, it's not. I support buying off the tool truck because they're small businesses like me, like some of you want to be. And I implore all of you guys to follow your dreams like that. A lot of these guys love their tool truck business. A lot of them love being a small business owner. Thanks for watching, guys. CP the Tool Addict. Remember, like, comment, share. Please subscribe. I know if you made it through the end of this video and you hate me or you like me or you hate me, maybe you should try subscribing. Check out my content. See if it's worth watching more. I think that I want to bring a different flavor to the tool community. I'm not like the Messiah of tools or anything like that, but I think I have some open perspectives and some things that I can bring to the tool community that will make things a little bit better for everybody. And I definitely love tools. That's my main passion for doing all this. So please think about subscribing. And if you don't like this video, give me a thumbs down. Tell me in that comment box what you'd like to see me change, what I can do to make it more interesting for you, or if there's anything at all. Thanks for watching, guys. CP the Tool Addict, on out of here. You'll be seeing a lot more of me because I'm going to be making a bunch of videos here, cold weather. Thanks a lot.